Hi everyone, it's Usman. And recently I had a meeting with some of our community members. And the one thing that we decided in the meeting was that I need to come up with a tutorial on how someone who is interested to contribute can set up a development environment with CyberPanel. So I'm going to describe a really easy way for you to set up a remote development environment for CyberPanel. I won't recommend setting it up locally. So for that, I just got myself a CyberPanel server, which I got from DigitalOcean, and I just deployed CyberPanel on it. And for development, I use PyCharm. You can use any IDE, but I recommend that you use PyCharm. So what you can do is just launch PyCharm and get the code from CyberPanel repository. So the CyberPanel repository is available at github.com/usmannasi/cyberpanel. Copy this URL, and once you open PyCharm, you have the option to create new project or open an existing new project. So you have a very sweet little option here that you can get start a new project from GitHub. So click Get from VSC and just paste the URL and click Clone. This will create a new project, and the code will be downloaded from CyberPanel repository. I already have configured it and already cloned this project from the CyberPanel repository, and the code is available on my machine. So this is the CyberPanel code base that you will get from the repository. You can do one more thing is that you can manually clone this repo somewhere on your file system or any folder of your Windows or Mac or Linux, and then you can open that folder from here as well. Alright, once that is done, you have to configure automatic uploads to the development server. So once you change any file here, it will be automatically deployed to the server, and you will be able to see the changes. For example, how you can do that with PyCharm is you can go to development and you can come to configurations. Here in configurations, I have already configured an SFTP deployment server. You can click on plus sign and click on SFTP. Just give it a name of development server and press OK. All right. So you need to configure the SSH details, and the IP of my server is this. I will copy this IP address and paste this IP address here. Right now I am using key-based authentication for uploading files, but you guys can use password or key-based authentication, up to you. For this tutorial I will use password authentication. So I will add my password and click OK. So I will test the connection to make sure everything is good. All right, the connection was successful. One more thing we have to do is we have to create a mapping. So CyberPanel code base is available at this location on server side. So you will come here and you just configure this connection. You can test the connection from here, and you have to come here and add the deployment path. So you will add this deployment path and you will press OK. So in this configuration, you have to set the default upload server. I will use this one as the default upload. So proceed, and the default upload server is now development server. So now whenever you also have to turn this automatic upload on. So now whenever you make any changes here, I will close all of these files first so that it is easy for you to understand. Okay, so for example, we want to make a cosmetic change on the login page. So I will go to this app, and one more thing that you need to have an understanding of how Django applications work, because it is CyberPanel is developed on Django web framework. So this is the login page. You can change anything like tutorial and control save, and you can see that here you can see that file is first it will login and upload the login file. All right, then I will need to do one more thing for this code to be applied. You can come here, SSH to this server, and enter the password. All right, so if I log out right now, you will see that my changes are not applied. What change I made was I written a web hosting control panel tutorial. Okay, for everyone is also written there. Okay, so now what I will do is I will just run a simple command here for this code to take effect. We'll now come here again. Okay, I think this is written somewhere. I will write it to, wait a second, I will write it beside the sign in button. I will come here, restart LSCPD, come back again, and you can see that tutorial is written here. So that's how you can change the HTML files. Now I will give another example. For example, I will change it back. Now for example, you want to do something when the website is created. I will log in again, and so if you want to do something when the website is created, there is a whole separate app for this that is called website functions. So if you open this file, if you know Django, you know that what are these views files, what are these URL files. So these are all the this is all the code. You can click submit website creation. So this is the function which runs when you click create website. So here you can like make any changes and it will be applied, but you have to run that systemctl restart lscpd. So this code basically calls the create virtual host function from this file plogical virtual host utilities, and this function is called. So we can actually see that what is this function. Okay, so here is this function. Okay, you can like make any changes here, and you will see that the changes will work on your CyberPanel installation. So I will just give an example. If you want to write to the log file when the website is created, you can. This is the global function that CyberPanel used to write to the CyberPanel main log file. For example, you want to write hello world to the log file. I will save, and this file will upload automatically to the server, and just come here, restart lscpd. Now come here and create the site helloworld.com. Non-7 persons, and create this site. And once the site creation is finished, you will see that the hello world is written on the main log file. You see, hello world is written. And whenever you make the any change to either HTML file or these Python files, you have to restart lscpd. And the one last thing that you have to do is, for example, if you make any changes to the static files, JavaScript files or CSS files, then you need to do one more thing, is that plus so you will have to change mod this file and then run this file. This will collect all the static files and make it available for you. For a person who knows how Django works, they will know that why we need to collect static files, and they will be able to figure it out. So if you have any questions, feel free to ask. And it was just a basic tutorial on how you can like edit the, for example, all the code related to databases, like how these databases are created is available here. You can edit this file, click save, the code will be uploaded, restart lscpd, and your changes will be applied. So thank you, and for any questions, feel free to ask in the comments.